Hello everybody, it's Els here, Elizabeth Craft Designs. How are you doing? I'm going to see if I see it should work, and then I want to see if the light is okay, because that's good, yeah, because I put the lights off because it was so shiny on the mat that I have here. So I thought I am going to turn the lights off, and it's good enough. Hi everybody, how are you doing? It's a Monday morning. What are we, the 20th of February? I don't even know. But hi, Lisbeth. Hi, Nikki. Hi, Janice, Madeline, and 13 other people. Hi, Lisanne, and Lisbeth, Wilma, Margaret, and 16 other people. Hi, everybody. So happy to be here. Hi, Linda. Hi, Annette. Oh, Annette, your Facebook Live was fabulous. Hi, Jackie. Jackie Jasper, if you don't follow her, look up Jackie, because she makes beautiful things. And then I see a name that I really don't know how to read. I'm sorry. It ends on Niba. Frida and 7 other people. Hello, everybody. So, hi, Terry. Hope you're doing okay. Oh, what are you going to tempt me to buy today? Oh, Erin, I'm going to work with stuff we already have. So, we should be fine. You just need some fun pictures. I'm going to work in my winter TN because, you know, I'm still in the winter here, of course. And I just love working in that. And I didn't find enough time to do that lately. So I thought I'm really going to do it in the live now so I can work with that. Yeah, it's absolutely gorgeous in that. So I have lots of nice winter pictures to put in my winter TN. So here you see I have that little winter word here that is from Sue Smith, the collection. And Sue Smith collection is on sale, the stamps. So if you go to our sales section, you can actually find the stamps. I think it's half off for a little bit. So, and I stamped this one. I want to use this one. I don't ever go today, but this is one of her stamps. Be brave, do good, stay you. So I thought that's a great saying. So I want to use that in my TN as well. Hi, Mariah. Hi, Tracy. Nice car, Tracy. Nice car. And so it's yeah, so playtime. And over here, it's gorgeous outside. I have to say, this morning, the picture we posted for the to announce the live was actually, I took that just when I drove up here to Josette's place. And it was absolutely gorgeous. And it was one of those mornings that I started with a lot of emails and, you know, like, that you think, okay, you know, not the most fun part of the business. And and then I looked outside, and we had fresh snow here, and it looked so gorgeous. And that's, you know, that just makes my mood turn around right away. I think, okay, gorgeous day. So that's why I took the picture, by just holding up that TN with a nice background. So I'm going to work in my TN, and of course that's the collection from Ilse and Charlene. Love, love, love working in this. And that's actually my own house. It's nice to see, because we're gone so long now that I need it. I need a reminder how my house looks. But so love it here, of course, in Canada. And so go to play in this one. So some stenciling. I have some ideas that I want to try. And that's what I do. Of course, I just play and then see what it gets to. And it's always going to be fun. So like, comment and share, Linda. Thank you. Which reminds me, Nina Couture won the $50 gift certificate from Friday. So Nina Couture, and email info@ecraftdesigns.com, and Angel will let you know how to collect your prize. So Nina Couture. And if you like, comment and share, you make a chance to win another $50 gift certificate. And on Wednesday, I will do the live. And on Friday, I have another guest here. So on Friday, it will be Rihanna from the Netherlands in English. So Rihanna will do the live on Friday, and she will work in the TN as well, or work with the collection. So that's going to be very, very fun. And I'm very excited to see it myself, because she's so talented. So it will be fun to see her. So on Wednesday, it will be me. And then on Friday, it will be Rihanna. So thank you already, of course, but that's going to be a fun one. So also from the Netherlands, we have some pretty talented people in the Netherlands. So this one, wait, I'm just going to, I want to add some kind of snow to this one before I'm going to use it. And that this is a flower, I think, that can be any season. So if you use it, you know, it's a You know, it can be any season. Yeah, Rieke, winterboekje. I love the winter. I love snow. That's honestly, every time I look outside the window, it's so gorgeous. And Charlene is here. So much fun. And Charlene, I want to have hearts for Charlene. She needs it. And that's, I know she doesn't want me to talk about anything, but Charlene needs love. So please send Charlene some love. And she's good. Charlene is a very positive person. So it's all fine. But we need some love for Charlene today. We need some love. We all need love. But there we go, Charlene. That's for you. You need all the love you can get. Here we go. You would give much, much heart if you also see the new collection they are working on. It is fabulous. So, a joy to work with. Charlene and Ilse are both a joy to work with, I have to say. It's fabulous, as all our designers, I have to say. Thank you all. That's lots of love. Thank you all. That's appreciated. That's appreciated. What is a dobber? Oh, the dobber is this one. That's... Charlene, you deserve it. So this is the embossed Debra from Ranger. It's one of those things I talked about a little bit earlier. This one is, I had it in my stash for like years, I think, probably. Never used it. And then honestly. It says October 2015. So if I say I had it for a few years, I'm not lying. I'm just seeing that now. So October 2015. So that if it doesn't work, that Ranger can say, but Els, do you know you have it for so long? But I never used it. It was, you know, sometimes you have those things and it's just sitting there. And then I started to use it and I love it. I love it. So it's, just one of those things. That's some things you don't know that you have anymore. And then it shows up and then you think, oh, that's great. And this is one of those items. Sorry, going to make some noise. Going to lift it up a bit. Wait, I'm going to use my tweezer because this is Josette's mat and I don't want to heat. I don't think that's one that we can heat that much. So I'm going to lift it up a bit. Hold it here. Hi, Marco, Rihanna. Hi. And while I'm doing this one, I'm going to do another one right away. And people in the Netherlands will recognize that one for sure. So that one. And then I had that's for my father-in-law, like a cutout thing. Well, I cut it out myself. Thanks, Dana. Yeah, old is new again. Yeah, exactly. So this is actually an old drawing from I love roodbosjes. How do you call that? Roodbosje in English. So can somebody look it up? I know how it's called, but I forgot. But it's not a redbreast. That's too easy. But it's so the bird. And I saw a picture from somebody on our Facebook group or on my Facebook feed. I don't know, that had a picture of this one in the snow. And it's such a beautiful bird. So I thought I'm going to etch it a little bit with the ink and then add some embossing powder as well. And I want to use that in my winter journal as well, because I just love that bird. And I don't... Robin, Red Robin. Thank you, Tracy. Thank you. So I just love that bird. I actually don't know if I've ever seen one in the US. I need to look that up. Do we have, for people in the US, do we have Red Robins here? I don't think I ever saw one. But so I cut it out. I'm going to etch a little bit with ink. I probably need to ask. Yes, thank you, Lena. So do people in the US, do we have that one in the US or in Canada for that matter? Because I don't know if I've ever seen one here. But I just love that bird. And so I thought I'm going to put it in there. And it's for two reasons. Because besides that I love that bird, it's also... this is from Marjolein Bastet. So, you know, everybody knows in the Netherlands, you know Marjolein Bastet. And she has a house in the US as well, I know. So she draws nature and she has calendars. And this is actually from one of her calendars. And my father-in-law saved those images. I saved them for years as well. Oh, we have them all over, Sandy. Really? Robins everywhere. I don't think I've ever seen one in the US. Maybe not in Colorado. Yeah, that's strange. So popular. Really, Terry? Really? I honestly don't think I've ever seen one in Colorado. I honestly think. Okay. Well, I need to look better then. I need to look better then because I honestly cannot remember that because I would have taken or tried to have taken a picture for sure. So I'm going to add a little bit of snow like here and then on the leaves. So that's just to show you that you can do a, you know, just use a clipping or because I love that. I love working with all kind of things that you find. Oh, Illinois and Ohio and in Colorado I just read. Well, that's something I need to look because honestly, I, you know, what I want to do is kind of cut this in so I can add a little bit of snow to some tips as well. Just a second. And then I can kind of move it around a bit, little bit. That should be enough. So just give it a little bit of snow on the sides of the leaves. And I think so for me, it's kind of so for two reasons. That I, well, my father-in-law loved this, that's for sure. And I actually have some paintings he made for me or for us hanging in our house. Yeah. First sign of spring. Okay. It's red later. It's a red letter day when you see the first robin. Oh, okay. What is a red letter day? What do you mean by that? I don't know. But if you look this up, you will find this you will find the drawings from Marie-Hélène Bastin everywhere. So you see, so my ink is a little bit too much, so then I just kind of tap it with my fingers. That's kind of because I don't want it to be a straight line. Because of course snow is nature, so you don't want to have that everywhere. So I'm just dipping that in different spaces. So again, on Friday you will be in for a treat again. We have Rihanna here, and the winner of the $50 gift certificate from Friday from the live from Annette. If you missed that one, watch it back because it's fabulous. She worked with she made the from the succulents from the flowers. Absolutely love it. And I cannot find little pots here in Banff, but I will find it when I'm going to the city and then get me some because I would love to try that because home decor is fun, of course, to do. So put this away. Kinder tag die in the butterfly book. The kinder tag die in the, okay. I don't know which tag die you mean, but you will answer for me, so that's good. Okay, and now put this one in here. I'm just going to find a nice spot for this in my TN. I'm just going to put that in right away because that will be on the page by itself, of course. Oh, you got your answer, Kim. Thank you. Yeah, Annette is, yes, Annette's work is really, really nice. Robins are winter in the UK. They appear a lot on Christmas cards. Yeah, yeah, Tracy, that's what I know, of course, yeah, from as well. So if they eat worms, they need me to be good. Yeah, of course, yeah, that's most birds, but yeah. Lace with it. Leuk roodbosje. Yeah, thank you. So I'm just going to find a page. And I want to have a page with some of the... Let me see. I'm just going to find a page. Yeah. And I just love... Because, you know, that's with the paper. Like, this paper is so gorgeous. It doesn't need much. So I'm just going to find a nice page. It could go here. That just stands out nice. Let's see which other one I find. Oh, this might be nice as well. Kind of frame it. Oh, I like that. You see, so that's the frame from the shaker card kind of thing. And then, so I like that. But I also might like a page with some brown in it. Or what do you like better? This one, I like it here. That's actually really nice. Okay, going to do it there. So going to add some glue. Yeah, Petronella, this is the art journal. So the TN from Ilse and Charlene. And that collection is really, really fun to work with, I have to say. It's small projects, of course. So that's what I like. So you can... my glue is getting thick. I need to kind of, so I like that it's small projects and just playing it. So I add pictures, so I kind of make it into an art journal, but I also add pictures just kind of to make it more personal. That's what I love to do with my journals. So just play, make fun pictures, and this one, so there's no picture involved, but I like it because it's kind of, I like the drawings. I should have done double-sided tape probably. Push that in there. Oh no, that's going to be fine. Here we go. You see, and now you just have a nice page in here. So this one is just a drawing that I like. I like the artist, and it reminds me of winter. So, but more, so I need to look for red robins in the US now, because I honestly haven't seen them yet. So I will do that. So that's just what you see, and that's ready. I can add more if I want to, but I don't think I need to. And then I had a great picture from James in the snow, and I wanted to add that one somewhere. That's just going to be a picture. Let me see. I had a picture that a page that I know I wanted to put it, and now I don't know anymore, but it can go anywhere, of course, can go here. And I'm going to work with some, I know I saw it somewhere that I thought, oh, it looks fun here, and it sticks out a little bit, which was okay. Just let me flip through this quick. That's I just wanted to add it here because it has the brown on it from James. And then you'll see a little bit of the picture here, which I don't mind at all. So I'm just going to put some double-sided adhesive behind this. But before I do that, I want to add some texture to this page as well, or something going on. And this is just a branch from Ilse and Charlene, which I like there because it has some heart. So I love that. So I might just do that. And then add the picture. And I think, oh, I didn't do this, because I had somewhere that I added embossing powder to that side as well. Let me show you that quickly. Because just the embossing powder will do so much to a lot of projects. And I know I had a sparkle as well. So this is the snowflake. So if I just add some embossing stuff here, and then add some of the powder, that will make it a nice... it stands out more. Yeah, Jonah, James is adorable. He is. He's a fun dog. Oh, this one yeah. And again, so you see, so now I do that on white, and I just take my finger and take off a little bit. And then I have a snowflake border there. Oh, I missed one spot here, which will be fine, of course, but I just going to add a little bit, and then it bended. So here we go, and then put this away, and let's just, you know, just play and have fun and create things. And especially with a kind of, you know, a Monday morning blues that I had this morning, it's fun to just play. Doesn't need to be like well thought of or whatever. You can just, you know, do whatever. And while I'm at it, you know, let me add a little bit of embossing powder on this side so I can heat emboss it right away. Then I have some snow on this page as well. Kind of fun. And that's kind of how I build my pages, just play. And then, you know, I like it bulky, so I just add things, and at the end it will be a very bulky journal. And do is done and say and down bewerken. Oh, I missed something again. You can also, I don't know if that's the question, but of course you can get your pages out and do that. But I just play in it like this. But if you want to get your pages out, of course you can do that as well, or prep your pages, because this is a Sue, it was a very short one. No, it was a very short, that's what I said. As soon as I looked outside, it was over. But it was, sometimes, you know, they start with a lot of emails that you think, oh, okay. But that happens. And of course, if you saw me, my pictures from yesterday, we had a fantastic day. Yeah, so if you saw my picture of yesterday, we were in, the kids went skiing, and we took a walk on the lake in Lake Louise, and that was absolutely gorgeous, I have to say. So, so yesterday was a really, really pretty day. So normally in the summer it's the blue lake, and now it was, it's frozen completely, and you can walk over it, walk towards the glacier a bit. And then we took a pathway along the lake back, and we saw a like a nice sled with the horses. So it was really, really pretty. Okay, so that one. And that's, again, that's one of my favorite branches, together with the one. So that's from the first release from Ilse and Charlene. That's just, you know, a branch that comes back the whole time. And I'm going to staple this one, I think, or with a little bit of tape, but I want to rough up the edges a little bit because I'm not going to mat it any further. So I just want to, it's not that straight. And then on the back, if you see that picture, you always notice you can, on the back, you can do a you can add a tea bag or whatever, just cover it, or a piece of paper, or another picture, of course. Thank you, Paula. Yeah, Wendy, it's easy to make a gorgeous journal if you have the products to work with. And that's honestly what we have from Ilse and Charlene, and from Esther, and from Sue. So there's so many, and from Josette, of course. So there are so many nice things that you can use. So it's just to play and mix and match, of course. So mix the, do a little bit of tape, and then I staple it. And so we have so much fun and nice products to work with. So it's just easy. If you have great designers, it's easy to make beautiful things. Graaf Belinda, snow's. Oh, the snow's a mess. Actually, you know, we had some, it's actually getting warmer here as well. So yesterday we had some slush as well. But then this morning we woke up to some fresh snow, but it's actually getting slush pretty easy at the moment because it's not as cold anymore. So it goes here. And then it sticks out a little bit, which is fine. And then I'm going to use my stapler just for fun. Let me see, can I staple here? Yeah, I can. And then I have the cutes. Where's my cutes? Oh, here. That actually can go on there. That's from the Reminiscence, the book. I think a lot of you have this by now. Just... yeah, this was the snow where James is in, was actually at our home. That was when we were home. It's we had a lot of snow, and he loves to dive in the snow. I have another one here that he actually looked up some wood. It's funny because he, of course, a beagle is a sniffer, so he has a very good nose. So we had a lot of snow on the deck, and then he went with his dove in with his nose somewhere, and he just got out. You know, he got his bone out. So it's amazing how they can sniffle. You're ready for spring now, Diane. Well, you know, here we have to wait for sure for a little bit. And I don't mind. I love the snow. It's, yeah, I love winter. So that's personal, of course. But, you know I will be ready for spring when it's that time. So we'll just wait and see. We're here for a little bit longer. You see, so that's a, you know, simple page, but I just love it. It's just, you know, it doesn't need so. And another one will be more artsy. And that's what I love to do. So it's yeah, fun. And then I love this branch as well. But I don't know where. Oh, but I put my letters in here. I know that. Wait. Oh, I love snow. You see, I cut those the first, like last week, I think. And then I used it here. And I got a cute picture here. But I need to cut out the cups from Esther here. You see, I have Tom here with the red nose and the hot chocolates. So that will be a fun one to use. And so these flowers I want to put somewhere for sure. Let me find a spot for those. Those can actually... no, I want a snowy picture here. This needs to be a snowy page. It's going to go somewhere on an empty page. And then I can... I still love this one. The winter scenery. So that's from the house. That's also from Ilse and Charlene. But I want to have those flowers somewhere. Maybe just here. That's nice. So I have some, I tried an embossing folder, or, oh, I made the embossing from the I used a die cut for the embossing here. So I'm going to add the flowers here, and then I can add a little picture there as well if I want to. So just give them a spot in my journal. And then just because I just love these flowers. And again, if you use these in spring in colors, then it will be a spring floral. That's going to be perfectly fine. So that's what I love about the collection. Be creative and just adding a little bit of color here. Yeah, Belinda, nice flowers. Oh, Lucy, yes, sunshine. I actually saw people. I saw pictures in a newspaper from people sitting on the canals, just like in the sun. You know, you do you take your own drinks or whatever. Or you can probably do pick up drinks at the restaurants there or food, and then just sit and enjoy that. I think that's just a great way, to spend your day. So that was actually a nice sight, I have to say. So last week people were ice skating on the canals, and now they are picnicking. You know, I'm going to put this picture here because this is one I love. This is just a picture from the wood stack we have at home, and again I love the snow on that, so I'm going to add this one here. And I'm just going to staple that, and then that's found place because I take a picture of like wood, like just outside. I have another one, and it's actually an older one that's from a fence here. I took that last year, I think, from Josette, from just a few houses down. Let's see if I can find that one. Oh, yeah, this is just here. This is a fence. That's from a house here just down the road. I love that. So snow is always beautiful. Rough this up a little bit as well. Not those straight edges. And, of course, you can mat this if you want to. And I will find a text to go with that and add that. So I'm just going to staple this one. Oh, there is actually something on the other page, but I can staple and that's not a problem if I do it on the edge. And then this one is going over like this, and then I need to glue it again, but the glue will still be wet. That's fine. Just press that down. And I'm going to find a date. Here I have the frosty border. I'm going to find the date with it because I always like to kind of know when it snowed or when the winter really started. So I'm going to find that. But you see just a little picture there. And I have one. Where is the... You want to put this behind it maybe? I could have put this behind it. I actually can still do that. Oh, I kind of like that, just as an extra, so it kind of brings the dark back a little bit. So I'm just going to add some glue to this one and then slide it underneath there. That's one of the new frames from Esther's Sidekick collection. And I see all the work is starting to show up on our ECD planner and journaling group with the new collection, and see so many fun things already. It's really, really nice. Okay, let me slide this under here. It's kind of nice that it brings back the color of the kind of the darker color that you see in the wood. And then I probably need to put a little piece of tape behind that. I will do that. Hoeveel pagina's doe je achter een elastiek? Oh, Saskia, I will count. I think with my other one I had seven double ones. But it also, of course, it's how thick you make it. But let me see. This is one. So here I have one, two, three. But this is a thin one. Three, four, five. Oh, six. Only six here. Six double ones. Here I have, let me see. Oh, I need to glue that down a bit. One, two, three, four, that's a five. Also six? Or is it seven? Wait. One, that's a thicker one. Two, three, four, five, no, six. Six as well. And in this one I have one, two, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So 6 or 7. And I think with the other one, I have, with the earlier one I make, I think I had 7 pages in between each. So how does it work, Petronella? Well, basically, so you cut your page, and I don't have the dies here, but Ilse and Charlene, you can find it on the website, of course. They have dies to cut the full pages. We have pockets. So this one, for instance, is one of the pockets, and it goes around. So basically what it is, you you just lift up your elastic bands and you slide it underneath there. So you slide your pages underneath. And I know there are people that just make pages, and as they go, they slide the pages in. What I like to do, because I'm, you know, I have a lot of different things, of course, I work on. I like to just cut paper. Cut paper first, put those in, and I can always change it. But I like to line up, because what I make here shows up on the other side here. Where is it? Where it's this one. Is it this one? Wait, let me see. I need to find it. So for this one, it is... Oh, this one. Is it this one? Yeah, so I covered the... So this one is the page, and then it shows up on the other side. Is that the one? I think it is the one. Well, let me find a clearer one. Sometimes you need to dig in. So this one, for instance, is the page. So this is one side, and then this is the other one. Yeah, the elastiques, yeah, Petronella, elastiques are already in the book. So you buy a TN, and it has the 3 elastic bands in it. Yeah, filling the page, yeah. Belinda, that's what I like to do. And in this case, I really wanted to use that Mystical Winter collection. So that's basically all the pages are Mystical Winter, because that's such a gorgeous paper pack that I really wanted to kind of showcase that and use that in this book. So so this is one side, you slide it in, and then it comes out on this side on the other end. So depending on what you do, like the middle page, you see this one, I made 2 windows. So that's the only page that actually the same paper shows up like opposite from each other. So on the, all the other pages, you always have another paper show up. So, and that's why I kind of like to organize that a little bit. Yeah, Petronella, it's super fun to use. Josette's collection in here, love to do that. Combined with the frosty border from Ilse and Charlene. So, and here the flower stamps, the houses are in their collection. And I just love to play like that. But everybody has their own way. Yeah, Belinda, the paper in this one is just gorgeous. But then Smile Always is from the Planner collection. And I made the shakers, I showed it. So there's a lot of videos already where I use this. I use this a lot, like those, you see September the 8th, kind of as a reminder when it was and where it was. So yeah, just love to play like that. Here's another one. That's, by the way, sold out now, but here at 2020, so this was in 2020. But I, you know, just find the date and kind of play with that. So inside, so this is really going to be my winter one. This one, I need to look up the date, but I know where it is. But and then I wanted to add the, because that one needs to go in, like because we bought a snow plow ourselves. But actually, right now I have neighbor. We have the best neighbors over there, and they are plowing our snowway for our driveway for a while now. So kind of feel guilty, but they are the best. So I want to have these in there. It's actually a nice color combination, you see. But I wanna. My idea was to try this one with some... So this is one of the dies from the collection from Esther. So I wanted to have some trees here. So you see this one is a little bit too big. So I'm going to cut this one. And I kind of like it on that, that it shines through. So I might just put this one there. So I'm going to trim this one a little bit smaller. Attend a workshop. I watch this. Okay, I'm trying to start with my planner. Tama, there's a lot. I don't know if you're part of the ECD planner and journaling group already. There's a lot of information on there and a lot of ideas, because honestly, we have the best people showing their work there. So if you go there, and we don't have a workshop anything scheduled now, but it's if you watch the ideas online, you will find a lot of ideas there. Yeah, Petronella, the schutpagina, you will find that online. You will find a video because I did that. So all our Facebook Live. So if you go to the Facebook page, you can actually find, you can find a lot of videos there. If you click on videos, you see that. So that's basically the workshops you can find there for free. So if you go on Facebook or you go to our YouTube channel, and maybe Anna can put in a link to our YouTube channel here, because Elizabeth Craft Designs, of course, we have a YouTube channel. So if you go to that, you will find a lot of ideas there. Because we put all our Facebook Lives on YouTube as well. So this one, just some glue. And now with this one, I need to add something in the back. Otherwise, I glue the pages together. And you don't want to do that. Do you do the base pages all at once? Yeah, Erin, that's what I do. But again, that's... in this case, and I did cut all the pages up front, and then I'm just starting to decorate. But for the people that are new, it's a loose leaf system. So if you put something in there, and I kind of try to, in this case, I try to organize the pages how I like the follow up, how I wanted it to be. But then I added this one later. That's one of the cutouts from Ilse and Charlene as well. And then I play. But because it's a loose leaf system, if you don't like the way it's organized, you can always, of course, you can always organize it later again. So it's not that it's a given how I have it right here. But I kind of, what I find out, I have glue everywhere. So it is a loose leaf system, but I find out that I don't do a lot of organizing after. Because it's, you know, I'm a lot of times I'm happy with the way it turned out, and I just leave it. I just leave it. So these pictures, I'm just going to put one here, maybe higher. Oh, no, I don't want to slide it underneath there. But I want to rough them up as well, because that's just what I like to do, because otherwise it's too stiff. And I might do some stenciling later, you know, that's... yeah, Belinda, thank you. It's that's why we put them on YouTube as well. So if you like, I think if you like our YouTube channel, you get notifications when something new is up. So it's always nice to watch back. And again, there's so many ideas on our family page and on our ECD planners and journaling. And of course, on the just on our Facebook, on the Elizabeth Craft Designs Facebook page, of course. Probably would love pictures of deer looking at. Oh yeah, that's actually so that's a from the picture where the deer is looking up, that is a that's actually you can buy sculptures like that for the I think I actually have one myself, but that's just really fun to do. Okay, so now my idea was to add a little bit of embossing powder to this. That's, I wanted to try that, so I'm just going to go for it. And then see how that turns out. So with my dauber, and of course I can also put put pages, like put things back, pieces that came out. But in this case, I thought if I can kind of do this a little bit like this. See how this works. See how this works. And again, check out the website also for the stamps from Sue, because like those charms are really, really nice to make with the stamps, because it's larger images. And then if you do that, it's just fun. New collection on US site when? Do you mean the Sidekick collection, Laura? I don't know exactly, sorry, I missed it. But Sidekick collection will take a little bit if you're looking for that one. So only available in stores right now. I cannot sort of get the grips with a small size journal. Interesting to see how it is possible to use the bigger dies. Oh yeah, there's so much, yeah. Oh, there's so much you can combine. Honestly, there's so much you can combine. And again, of course, all the dies from Ilse and Charlene work in this, but I love to play with the different collections. Kind of works out well, like that look. And now I want to do try it here as well, but it of course keeps the holes there, but that's okay. Let's see how that's going to turn out. It's going to be interesting to see. Somebody had a brain freeze. Happens to the best of us. All the time. Okay, let's see. Get this out of the way. That's a fun effect, I think. This back. And then emboss this one. I think that's fun. It's going to be fun. So this one was a paper bag, I think, yeah, because you see the seam here from the bag. So a paper bag I used, and I cut out a pattern from one of the dies from Ilse and Charlene. And then, yeah, so that's fun. Like that. I have that still the little branch here. And I do have the leftover pieces from this one that I could actually put at the bottom, but I don't think it needs it. I think we're fine here. Of course, I can do a little bit of... Oh, let's do that. You see, I have those here, the leftover pieces, but it doesn't need that. Although it actually looks fun, but then I need to add embossing powder to that again. Now, you know what I'm going to do? I'm just going to add a little bit of the snow here by just doing this. Because I want it to be a snowy page. I only do it on this side. That's fun. That's good enough. And then I can add my pictures. And if you look at the, because I know we have videos up from Charlene as well. If you look at that, you will see she has a totally different, she's more archy-fartsy. I'm more just playing. And Ilse and Charlene have a more archy way of working with more paint. And sometimes I do that as well, but a lot of stenciling. I have stenciling in here as well. I love the stencils. Love the stencils, but... Right now, I'm just doing the embossing powder. Yeah, but if you look at the stencils that we have from the collection, of course, I use this one already in here. So there's lots and lots to work with. I could. Oh, wait, let's get this one out. I will add some snow to this one. Here, let's do that. Of course, you can also take just a... like a splatter of paint, but this one will be fun here. Oh yeah, cool. I do have a spatula here with, I need to use this one because I think I forgot my, so I have a texture paste transparent matte and transparent shiny. I forgot my opaque one to bring on this trip. So I'm just going to use this one. This is the modeling paste from Finnebar. And that's great. It just needs a little bit more time to dry. So then I need to find something else to do in between. And of course, you can also, take white ink or something. But I think the texture from paste is nice. So just use this one. And of course, just give it some. I'm going to do it over the tree as well a bit. And this is just way, you know, my way of just working relaxed, and you know, it's always going to be fine. And again, if it doesn't turn out as I want it to be, I can take the page out. But normally it doesn't happen that much, because you can do some layers, you can, you know, put a tea bag over things. You know, we use a lot of tea bags. So just if you have something that you think, oh, you know, doesn't show up as I would like it to be, then you can change that again. Layers. Okay, I think this is fun for here. Should I go all the way down? No, not all the way down. This is it. Ah, that came out cool. Love that. Now it's really snowing. That's actually a good page now for the picture because that's fun. You see, now it snows. And it was snowing when we did the snow plowing. So that's actually cool. And I might, you know, maybe I put another picture up later. I can do that one as well. Thank you, Terry. Again, it's fun to it's fun to do. It's fun to work with. I just play. Clean my spatula. Otherwise, it's going to stick to it. Oh, it's really snowing where you are, Jen. Yeah. No, not anymore here. Although it's very foggy because we don't see the top of the mountain at the moment. So it's getting very foggy. You know, talking about foggy, this is a picture just outside when it just snowed. Like that's in Colorado. So that's actually nice and foggy there. And then here I have one from a clear sky. You see, so all those pictures I want to have in my journal just to, you know, see the... all the different stages of snow. And I have this. Let me see if I want to add this one here. Love this. No, it's going on another page. Let me see. I need to dry this a little bit. Sorry, I have a lot of drying stuff to do here. So I just need to blow dry this a bit. And carefully, otherwise it burns. Raining in Connecticut. Yeah, then snow is better. Is the stencil pack sold out, Penny? I will check for that. I need to see. I will get information about that. Or Anna, maybe you can check if the stencil pack from the winter Mystical Winter Collection is sold out. Carol, hello, I'm new here. Glad I found you. Welcome, Carol. And I don't know if you heard it, but if you like, comment and share this video, this live, you make a chance to win a $50 gift certificate. We do that with each live, so 3 times a week. Like, comment, and share. And you make a chance for the $50 gift certificate. But welcome. I hope you enjoy it. Is this dry? Yeah, it's a little bit dry already. That's fine. So now I'm thinking, you know, this will be nice on here as well. I'm going to do this one. I like that picture. I'm going to use that one there. Because then you still see some of the tree. Which I like. I have so many nice pictures. That's actually in on the hill here. Let me see. Because that's, of course, the system I can use which one I like. Oh, this color-wise, this is cute as well. So I'm going to use that one here. And then Joops should go here. Or I find another place for you. No, Joops should go in first because he's cleaning more snow than I do. This, my picture is just like a tryout, but I have to say I'm not a snow shoveler. Joop is, so he should go here and not me. Well, I should put Steve there, my neighbor, because he's cleaning the snow. But I honestly think Joop likes cleaning the snow because then it's also always nice outside and he doesn't mind, I'm pretty sure. That's the way it should be, Terry, about the cleaning the snow. You know, I like it. You know, I love snow. So for me, I wouldn't mind, actually. But yeah, let me see if I can kind of slide this underneath here a bit. This is glued down. Yeah, so slide it underneath the tree. And then do it like that. And then I might need a little staple as well. Do you want to stay? Then I need to kind of figure out where I want to staple because here we go. Then at least it stays there. Because if I turn the page, you see, so that's just a page, and I might add something here or you know, just see. But you know, that's a little corner that's still empty, but I can do that. And then I'm just going to leave this like now for this. I might add a little bit of falling snow here, just here on this side. But that's something I can do later. Because, and I can just put the word this here. Let me see, I still like that heart, but it's not the right color. So what if I add a little bit of embossing powder to that? It's embossing powder galore this morning, but if I a little bit of this to make the heart not this, because I like to see it a little bit more matching with the page. Let's see. And if I don't like it, I just don't use it. That's how easy it is. And this one has double side. And this is from one of the, I think this is also Planner Essentials. Sometimes I lose track about what everything is, but yeah, pick collage for the pictures. Yeah, I use that. Thank you, Tracy, for answering. I see you're answering all kind of questions from everybody, so thank you for that. Because I miss a lot of comments. Okay, so just make it not too even. Let's see if this is going to work. Put that aside. Get my tweezer out. Oh, now I kind of mess it up here. But that's fine. Let's see. And then I can use that. Did we get an answer on the stencil pack if it's sold out? If it is, I think we reordered, but I don't know for sure. So if we don't get an answer now, I will get back to it. Oh yeah, I like that. Love this. Oh yeah, cool. So this is also... So this is also Planner Essentials. Oh, now of course I have sticky, but I don't think that was... No, that's fine. I might need to add something on the back now, because now the sticky comes through. Love this. You see, but because it's thicker already, so it is, you hardly feel it, but there is some sticky, so I need to add something here now. But I can do that easily, of course. I have another... Maybe I'll put my own picture there, or another one. Let me see. Of that one, maybe I put this one here, because that's actually, so that's both in Colorado. So I'm just going to stick this one here, and that's will shine through here, but that's fine. You see, so you see a little bit of white through here, but that's fine, because this kind of matches the rest. So let me do that. And so at the end, this will be a journal with only winter pictures in there. And I know, like, in the Netherlands, you had so many beautiful winter pictures. My goodies, it's nice. It was so pretty. And so I saw winter pictures from last week. And then this week, I saw people walking on the beach again because it was beautiful weather. So that's the Netherlands. So now on this one, I need to be careful that I'm going to staple this one. Because if I glue this now, then I have glue again on this side. So those are things you need to think about. So I'm going to staple this one. And I have the letters here. So it's going to kind of go here. But before I do that, I also want to add one of those frames then. You see, so I'm going to add this to here. So I have that coming back. Yeah, I like that. And then I'm definitely going to do something here. But again, I can do that later. But let me staple this one. I don't know if Ilse is here, but she's the staple queen. And Charlene, by the way, as well. But it's just so easy to do. And a staple every now and then, that can show up on the other side. It's totally fine. So I'm just going to do, and it will show up in the middle of the tree, probably. But that is fine. Where's it? Yeah, oh, in the paper, actually. But that's fine. And then this one, I will do another one here. So this is the mini stapler from Tim Holtz. Don't rub it in. Oh, mijn hele bureau, Wendy. Nee, dat wil je niet zien. It's not a desk. It's actually a table here at your Zed's house. So, but I'm getting used to just cleaning up and then organizing again. So that's it. You know, it's not a bed. It's not a bed. But at the little house we are renting right now, it's too small for... I cannot do the live from there. First of all, the internet is too bad. But it's also... the table is too small. If I'm doing the live from the office in Colorado, I'm actually more organized because... There, I go to the office or to the studio, and I know exactly what I'm going to do. And here, I kind of take stuff with me, and then I organize. You see, so that's actually cool. So I'm going to find a date for this because I kind of want to know when this is. I might add a little piece of. Oh, I can actually put a little piece of tape there. Oh yeah, okay. Let me do that, and then that will stick. Oh, maak ze met een grote Canon printer. Easy print, ja. Yeah. So Marja, de kleine leuke foto's. I think you got the answer. But it's this. I use the Canon selfie printer. And that's easy because you can just print from your phone right away. And it just works very easy. And then you can choose your own layout. For instance, like you can do three in a row here. And then you have, so this for instance would be one print. So you have six little pictures there. So you can do that. So you can do all kind of different layouts. You can choose larger. So it gives you all different options. And that is actually, that works really nicely. So, but I see here that people work with a large printer as well. That will probably be more cost effective, could be. But I just have, you know, for me it's easy. I travel a lot. So if I travel, I can take my selfie printer. And you just connect to the internet. So for me, that is really, really easy to do. Just finished my camera album last evening. Oh, Marianne, the camera. That's just one of everybody's favorites, I think. But okay, so here we have this. And again, I'm going to stencil a little bit here, probably. But that's, or I add another picture. And there's another, like this one. I love these stamps. I love these stamps. So this one would go nicely here. So I might do that. But that's for another time. Or I might do another flower like this. Let it come back on the other side. But that's, you know, that's all something to think about. So still lots of fun stuff to work with. So since we have some new people, I will do a little flip through. And what's fun to use as well is the burlap. So I have different colors of burlap here that I can use. There's tape on here. But you see, so I use that in there. This is actually a tea bag that's kind of the same color as the burlap, so can use that. These are handles from paper bags, so you know, so that's all fun stuff to work with. So lots and lots of possibilities, lots of possibilities. So let me, you see, so here I made this winter. That's at home. This is from one of the Suzanne Cannon. This was in 2020. But it's going to go into 2021. So I make those same letters because that's from the collection from Ilse and Charlene. So I'll make the same ones 2021 because I have a lot of pictures in here from 2021. You see, that's Lake Louise. That's where I was yesterday. So maybe I add a little picture there from yesterday. This was Emerald Lake Lodge. We went there. This is the pocket die that will have a pocket on the other side. This is from the collection from Ilse and Charlene. A shaker one here, you see shaker card. So this is one of my videos. So if you want to see how I did this with this in here, you can find that on, if you click on videos, you will find it, or on our YouTube channel. So these, basically, I think almost everything in here, I created during the lives. Call it like, that's one of the stamps. That's actually a fantastic stamp as well. So of course we have the boys and the girls, but this one has the, let me see here, the winter bird on it. And you see the owl, the birds, the antlers, and the feet. And this little branch, that's this one. That's actually that longer branch. Oh, no, that's an antler. This is one of the antlers that I put there. Stencil here from Ilse and Charlene. You see, and that's... I actually love that. But, you know, just the page, that's just... We have James in the snow as well. I need to have the kids' pictures in here that I just took. Because I notice I have James in here, but not kids yet. That is not good. I might just play with that today. Because I have all the pictures of the kids. Here I have a fun picture from the... I have the ski pictures here. I have a lot of pictures from the kids from the since we are here. Yeah, the two skiing ones. Like and the one with Josette with Annika at school. So lots and lots. So they're going in here. That's the next definitely your next one. I just see that. I have deer in here, which is nice as well. Okay, so that's it for today, you see. So just lots of fun to work in this one. And then, you know, elastic band around it. And what's fun about the system as well. So this will, you know, this can damage a little bit. That's all fine. It will stick out a little bit depending how bulky you make it. But how did you make the tags? Oh, I don't know what you mean with that T. So if you, where do I have tags? I don't know where I have tags, but there are tags in it. Like this one, for instance, is in the collection from Ilse and Charlene. Yeah, Snoopy is a beagle. Yes, somebody sent me that. Yeah, somebody sent me that info as well. But this is one that comes with the die sets. So there are, Ilse and Charlene have two die sets with tags. So it has a pocket then, and it has the tags in there. Alrighty, well, thank you so much for watching. And I see you again on Wednesday. And on Friday, it will be Rihanna. So make sure to make a note of that one, because that will be really, really fun to watch as well. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.